In this video, I'll be showing you how to track chatbot conversations as conversions inside Google Ads using Google Tag Manager. So this can get pretty complicated pretty fast. It can change based on the chatbot that you're using. So follow along closely, but be aware that your variables and triggers and tags inside of Google Tag Manager may change based on the chatbot that you are using. So to get started, we're going to need to be inside the conversion action section inside Google Ads. To get there, you'll go to goals on the left-hand side, click summary, and you'll be here. And in Google Tag Manager, we're going to need to have that completely set up on the website we are trying to track conversions on. To get started, we're going to go ahead and preview the website. This is to help us get all the variables that we'll need. So preview the website, go ahead and type in the website right here, click connect. From here, once this section pops up, you're going to want to click on the chatbot. Once we're in here, we're going to want to let the person know that whoever runs the website, that this is a test, so that way they aren't responding to this and getting excited about a potential lead while we're actually just testing out the system. So going ahead and put in the name, phone number, and message. This will obviously change based on the chatbot and the features here. If the chatbot just asks you to send a message, all you need to do is type in and send a message. But here we're going to type in another test, please ignore. Then we're going to click send. From here, we can minimize this window and we can see in the tag assistant on the left-hand side that the web chat widget was triggered. We're going to go to this most recent one. This one shows that we sent a message. We'll click this drop down arrow, and from here you can see that the action conversation started was triggered, and you can see that this was obviously the event was web chat widget. This is the information that we will use inside Google Tag Manager to get the tags to fire only when somebody starts the conversation. From here, we're going to go back to Google Tag Manager. We're going to go to variables. We're going to click new. From here, we're going to click variable configuration, click data layer variable. Now that we're here, we are going to go to tag assistant and we are going to copy and paste event action in this exact format, capitalization and no spaces. Paste it in here to the data layer variable name. Click save. From here, we're going to go to triggers. Click new. Click trigger configuration. Scroll down. Click custom event. For the event name, we are going to go back to our tag assistant and we are going to copy and paste this wording right here. Do not copy and paste the quotation marks, just whatever shows up right here. This may vary based on the chatbot plugin that you are using, but you will want to copy and paste exactly whatever is next to event. So we're going to copy, paste that into event name. Then we're going to click some custom events. We're going to click chatbot variable, click equals, go back to the tag assistant, and we will copy and paste this section right here. Do not copy the quotation marks. And it's whatever is showing right next to event action. So this also may be different compared based on the chatbot that you were using. Go back to Google Tag Manager, we'll paste that in there. We'll click save. We're going to name this chatbot trigger. Click save. From here, we are now going to go up to tags, click new, click tag configuration. We're going to go to Google Ads conversion tracking. From here, we are now going to go back to Google Ads, click new conversion action, click website, scan the website, making sure that your Google Tag Manager was set up properly. From here, we're going to click add a conversion action manually. I'm going to click contact. We're going to name this Chatbot Creekside. So they know that we here at Creekside Marketing were the ones responsible for setting all this up. We're going to click value and use the same value for each conversion. Go down to count, click one. We're going to click done. From here, we're going to click save and continue. From here, we're going to click use Google Tag Manager. We're going to copy this conversion ID, go back to Google Tags, paste it into the conversion ID section, back to Google Ads, copy the conversion label, paste it into the conversion label section. Now we're going to scroll down and type in whatever we had typed into conversion value here. Go to triggering, click on chatbot trigger, click save. Or I'm going to put in the middle here, chatbot, click save, and click submit. For the version name, we're going to put chatbot conversion tracking for Google Ads. Click publish. And from there, we are going to go back to Google Ads, click done, and we are just going to confirm that this works by going back in, opening up this window, clicking X here, and then we're going to click text us again, and then we will type in our message, we'll click send, and once you send another message, I'm going to say this is the final test. Thank you for your patience. However the hell you spell that word. Perfect. Click send. Once that has been sent, we can exit out of this. We can come back here, click reload. We actually need to go in and type in the website ourselves up here because the previous Google Tag Manager version did not have this conversion tracking in it. So now that we've submitted it and updated it, we're going to go in and click text us, and we will put in one more message. Test, click send. Now that this is sent, we should be able to come back here and see that the chatbot Creekside is now tracking conversions. And you'll now see that the status shows no recent conversions, which means the chatbot conversion tracking is working. If this still shows that it's inactive, you may have missed a step or mistyped in something when setting up the Google Tag Manager. It's also a possibility that your entire Tag Manager account isn't set up properly, but feel free to reach out to us and ask any questions. We've done this a lot for tons of different clients, so we've gone through all the troubles that are associated with Google Tag Manager and conversion tracking. So we'd love to hear from you, but hope this helps, and you should be good to go.